Watch the Powerball drawing live tonight here on TV 23. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV 23 studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. You know what? It's Wednesday, September 23rd, 2015. This is High Plains Today. On today's show, McKensie Hood. She is the director of the Seward County United Way. We're going to be talking about their kickoff golf tournament that takes place this weekend and a bunch of other stuff about United Way. Let's take a quick look at some area news. A 24-year-old Garden City man has been accused of having sexual intercourse with a child between the ages of 14 and 16. Finney County Attorney Susan Rickmeyer said Terry Walter Hoffpower III has been charged with aggravated indecent liberties with a child. Finney County Sheriff's deputies arrested Hoffpower last Thursday. He is being held without bond. And Nicholas Warish, owner of the ice cream shop and Jorito's Alignment, a garage at 208 South Main in Garden City, is determined to rebuild from the fire that destroyed his business. Fire started at about 6:30 p.m. August 23rd at Pelletaria Jorito's, an ice cream shop at 214 South Main, and eventually spread north to an adjacent warehouse full of tires. Cause of the fire is still undetermined, according to the Kansas Fire Marshal's Office. Warish, who opened his garage in 1999, has no plans to move. He said they are trying to squeeze in tires wherever they can since they don't have the warehouse, but he hopes to purchase the land so he can rebuild the warehouse. Three people were sent to the hospital with minor injuries when a 14-year-old turned her car in front of two motorcycles Saturday night. According to the Liberal Police Department, on Saturday at about 8:50 p.m., emergency responders were dispatched to 15th and Kansas Avenue for a report of an injury accident involving a motorcycle. Responding officers found that a motorcycle collided with a Ford Mustang. Investigating officers learned that a Ford Mustang, driven by a 14-year-old female, was turning east from North Kansas Avenue. A Harley Davidson, driven by a 26-year-old male, was traveling north. The driver of the Mustang did not yield to the motorcycle. And the Kismet Public Library Foundation will host a meeting at 7 p.m. Saturday the 29th, or September the 29th, to share the opportunities available for Kansas taxpayers and the Kismet community through the Kansas Tax Credit Program. Now, the meeting will be at the Kismet Pavilion. Recently, the Kismet Public Library Foundation received the Kansas Department of Commerce Community Service Tax Credit Grant for 2015-16. Donations for the Kismet Public Library Foundation Library Building Project are eligible for a 70% tax credit. El Dorado officials are searching for the person or persons who have disrupted school activities twice in 10 days with threats on social media. El Dorado High School was locked down on Monday for about 2 hours after a student reported a threat on social media. All rooms were screened before students were released on schedule. Now, on September 11th, El Dorado's football game against Augusta was postponed because of another threat on social media. The game was played 2 days later. School officials said in a news release, the district will seek to discipline or prosecute those responsible for the threats. The decision by state regulators to limit injection of salt water deep underground after drawn to the surface by oil producers coincided with diminished intensity of earthquakes in south central Kansas. The Kansas Corporation Commission is poised to renew for another 6 months the injection restraints applicable in Harper and Sumner counties that were inspired by the proliferation of earthquakes rattling the region's residents. And finally, the Kansas Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism net $90,000 in an auction in Salina on Saturday. The auction consisted of items of over 5 years' worth of search and seizures from all over the state. Items included guns, boats, jet skis, traps, and deer heads. A trophy deer head expected to bring in the biggest bucks. Get that? No pun intended. See what I did there? The bucks, big. Anyway, removed from the auction because of an ownership dispute. The near-record 14-point white-tailed deer was illegally shot in Osage County in 2011. The trophy head was the second highest scoring in Kansas. Now, the owners of the private land where it was shot are fighting for ownership of the deer head. And that's a look at some of the things that are happening out there. Stick around. I'll be back with some weather right after this.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell. TV23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
You want to feel connected, at one with your world. Informed, included, and inspired. So no matter where you are, when important things happen, we're here at all hours. In the moment, on every screen in your life. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. We investigate and inform, give back to the community, build the local economy, even save lives. America's number one source for news, weather, and information. And unlike any other news source, we're here. 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 And here. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Two outs with a runner on first base. Now the big guy comes up with that, hitting 342 with 92 RBIs and 36 home runs.
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
There's something I feel when I'm right here. Something that tells me that.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
Welcome back as we look off to the northeast on the TV 23 Tower Cam. You can see there's a few high clouds left over from the showers that rolled through here earlier. Looking at our temperatures here at the station, 72 degrees, yep, relative humidity, 75. Winds are out of the south at 12. The barometric pressure is on the rise. Looking at our current temps, everybody pretty much in the 70s and 60s, even all the way over to Medicine Lodge. Current dew points out there, you can see Elkhart has the lowest at 54. Everybody else pretty much in the mid-60s, mid-50s, upper 50s. So that's why the humidity is so high and the temperature is so low. Then you get the heat anyway. Looking at the winds, we're looking at most of the winds are pretty much out of the south in the teens. And looking at our recorded highs and lows yesterday at the Garden City Regional Airport, 88 was the high yesterday, 92 back in 1968, 66 overnight, 29 the low back in 1995. I didn't realize that. Looking at the precipitation, last night we had only 0.03 in the bucket in Garden City. Today's forecast, high of 81, 80% chance of rain. It's going to kind of hang around all day. Winds are going to pick up. They're going to be out of the south at 23 then tonight. 60 degrees, 60% chance of rain hanging around. Winds out of the south at 14. Tomorrow, still a 20% chance of rain hanging around. Yeah, maybe out of here by noon. 82 is the high. Winds are going to be out of the south at 10. They're going to be shifting to the west tomorrow afternoon. And then looking at tomorrow night, 58 degrees at chance of rain, 20%. Northeast winds at 10. As we look at the 7-day, you can see that chance of rain. 80% today, 20 tomorrow. Friday, ooh, not bad. Saturday especially, United Way Golf Tournament, going to be a beautiful day. Summer is just hanging around, even though this is the first day of fall. Lows are going to be in the 60s and 50s. That's a look at the 7-day. We'll be back with markets after this.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
I did. Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you know that strollers have the right of way on the sidewalk?
Yes.
Yep, I did. Did you guys
did
know?
Did you know that kids who eat breakfast have higher GPAs?
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Yeah. That's actually what I was going to say.
Did you know babies should never touch silver? It's really bad for them.
I knew that.
Did you guys know that statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat at the right age and size. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
I'm putting that on my blog.
I just put it in mine.
Lead paint poisoning affects 1 million children today. If you're pregnant or have young children and your home was built before 1978, you could be at risk. Learn how to protect your family. To find your home's danger zones, the health effects, or just to find help, log on to leadfreekids.org.
Same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
Lead paint poisoning affects 1 million children today. If you're pregnant or have young children and your home was built before 1978, you could be at risk. Learn how to protect your family. To find your home's danger zones, the health effects, or just to find help, log on to leadfreekids.org.
Welcome back. I am now joined by Ms. McKensie Hood. She is the director of the Seward County United Way. She has a big kickoff campaign coming up on Saturday.
I do. It's a four-person golf scramble at Willow Tree Golf Course.
Yeah, that's a big deal.
Yeah, we're really excited.
And the weather's going to be good. We looked at that.
That's what you just said, so I hope it holds out.
I'm not a weather man. I'm just a weather reader. So.
Well, I hope it's true. I think it's going to be great weather, and I think it's going to be great community members out there helping and playing some golf and just excited to kick off our 2016 campaign.
Okay, so kicking off the United Way campaign, let's do, for those out there that don't understand United Way, let's do like a quick 101 on it. Now, why would I want to give to the United Way?
All right, well, our Seward County United Way has 26 agencies that we help support. When you donate to United Way, your money goes to those 26 agencies. Money doesn't leave Seward County. A lot of people, I think, have that misconception that it does. We do have to pay national fees, but that's less than 1% of what we make during campaign.
That's not very much.
No, it's
so
not
there's a
very
lot of
much
it,
at all.
There's a lot of it that is staying in Seward County.
Yes, and it helps outside of Seward County even. We even go into Oklahoma. Turpin and Tyrone are also in our area, and we're also pushing maybe going more towards Guymon area.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Okay, because, do they not have United Way programs or organizations that far or what?
They have the agencies.
Okay.
But they don't have the United Way supporting them.
Like, a lot
of people know, the panhandle kind of gets lost. And so being in the Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas panhandle, they kind of get lost, and we're just kind of out there by ourselves. And so I'm really working on maybe stretching out and reaching out to the different communities that don't have anyone helping support them.
And you grew up in Perryton.
I did.
And you went to school at Oklahoma State.
I did.
So, and living in Liberal, you know the panhandle very well, so you don't forget it.
I do.
Okay.
And Liberal's actually a big city for me. That's where we went to go to Walmart from Perryton, so it's big city for me.
All right. So you have all these agencies that you work with, 26 of them, like the Stepping Stone Shelter, the Red Cross, the Boy Scouts, the Girl Scouts, Head Start, Kansas Children's Service League. You know, just you got 26 of them. Mm-hmm. Now, when they need something or whatever, you just don't go to them and say, hey, want some money. It doesn't work that way, does it?
No, it doesn't. We actually have an allocation process that's every 2 years, and it's actually coming up this January. And I have an allocation board, and each agency comes, and they have tons of paperwork they have to fill out of all their expenses, how much money they're really needing to pretty much keep their lights on. And so they come, and they present it to the board. And then the allocation board discusses it, goes through all their paperwork, and we decide how much we allocate to each business.
So you have an
agency.
You have an interview process
yes.
to be able to donate to these agencies, so it's not just cut and dried.
No.
Okay.
It's definitely a process.
All right. So if they need help, then do they contact you, or what do they do? I mean, if there's an agency out there, one of the 26 that you're not taking care of now, do they just call the Seward County United Way and ba-bam? Guys set up an interview, or how does that work?
Okay, so if someone calls us that's not one of our 26 agencies, like Bright Futures, for example.
Sure, yes.
And
yes.
They're an awesome agency in our community. They're helping with the schools, and we actually partnered with them to do the school supplies this year. I've talked to them about becoming an agency, and so in January when we do our allocation process, they are more than welcome to come in and present and share with us why they want to be funded by United Way. And like I said, we already support them. We think they're a great agency, and I think we would love to have them on board. But if they aren't needing that funding and that extra help, like I said, to keep their lights on or to give those programs to students, they probably wouldn't be considered. But if they do need that help, then we definitely consider them.
Now, if you want to donate to United Way, there's more than one way to do it, right? Mm-hmm. You just don't go, you know, make a check out United Way, whatever, right?
You can. You can make a check out and drop it by my office, whatever you want. But there also, you can do online giving, which is on our website at scunitedway.com. You can go on there, and it's through PayPal, and that goes direct to United Way. You can also do payroll deduction at your business. There's a lot of businesses in Seward County that do payroll deduction. One of our huge givers is National Beef, and I can't say enough about their employees. They truly, truly believe in United Way and our 26 agencies, and we really appreciate it.
Okay, so with the payroll deductions, now, do the employers also kick in to the fund?
Yes, a lot of times the employers match what their employees give, and so that's also a major contribution to United Way.
So if you work for an employer that matches for every, say, $5 you give, then really United Way is getting $10, and then that $10 in turn is going to stay in the community with Seward County United Way.
Yes. My slogan is money donated here stays here. So everything that you're donating is going to help someone. It could be your neighbor. It could be your family. It could be a kid in your students or a student in your kid's class. It could be literally anyone. There's so many people that need help in Seward County that a lot of people probably don't realize need the help, and our services are there for everyone.
Okay, so let's talk about Saturday, your big golf tournament coming up at Willow Tree.
Yes, I'm super excited. It's a four-person scramble. It will. It's a shotgun tee time at 9 a.m. So find three of your friends and bring them out. It's $75 per player, but we're also going to have huge cash prizes for winners, and we're going to have huge hole prizes that National Beef has donated. And that evening will be a dinner at 6:30, and it is open to the public. Billy's Blue Duck Barbecue. That's a tongue twister.
That's a mouthful. That's a mouthful, isn't it?
They are going to be there providing the dinner, and so it's just going to be a fun evening. We're going to talk about our campaign goal for 2016. We're going to announce winners. We're going to do some raffles for people that are there. So if you're interested in getting tickets or coming out to play, you can call me at my office, or you can come by First National Bank where I'm located and purchase some tickets, or you can purchase them that day. And sign up is open until Saturday morning. So
there you go.
So just come sometime before 9 and sign up and come play.
Okay, so the dinner, is it going to be out at Willow Tree Saturday night also?
Yes, we have the big white Mead Lumber tent, and it's going to be on the 18th hole. So it's going to be beautiful weather, like you said earlier, and it's just going to be a fun evening. And like I said, just to be with our community and just have a good night.
And all that money goes to United Way.
Yes.
So it's, you're donating money back to United Way and Seward County.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. And a lot of people don't know. You know, I know not everyone needs the services that the 26 agencies have, but one of our agencies is Kids Inc. And I know that in Liberal and Seward County and surrounding counties, everyone puts their kids in Kids Inc. I mean, it's an awesome, awesome agency, getting them involved in sports early. And so even if you might think you're not using the services, you are. So.
Well, yeah, because Kids Inc. needs uniforms and equipment. I mean, because they have the football. They have tackle football. They have flag football. Mm-hmm. They have soccer. They have girls basketball. They have boys basketball.
They have volleyball.
They have all that stuff. So they need help, too.
Mm-hmm.
And you have Crossroads Center is also on there.
Yes.
Liberal Area Rape Crisis and Violence Center is on there. So there's all kinds of stuff. Mm-hmm. I love your slogan, though, money donated here stays here.
Yes, and I think that's just important. Like I said, I'm from a small town. I'm from Perryton. And I know that there's so many people in our local community that needs help. And so with these local agencies and United Way, we're helping those people. And we have so many different cultures in our community now. Someone told me we had over like 63 languages now in Seward County, which is just mind-blowing. But I think it's awesome. I mean, it's awesome that we're getting different cultures in, and we're all learning with that. And that's, you know, the agencies, with the funding they get from us, it helps them prepare for these different languages, and so they can accommodate them and help them emerge into our culture.
So what's your goal for 2016, money raised?
Okay, it's kind of a secret.
But all right, that's fine. You don't have to tell me.
I can tell
you.
Well,
last year was what, $300,000?
$340,000.
$340,000, and you made that?
No, Kay did not make it last year. It was her first year not to make goal. But we ended up actually getting a large donation after I took over, and so it evened it out that we made
it.
Okay. And last year.
So this coming year, are you going to have, is it a bigger goal?
It's $340,000.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm. So you want to donate money to a great cause. You want it to stay in Seward County. Go see this young lady. Get a hold of her and donate to the United Way. And if you're not doing anything Saturday, get in her golf tournament, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah, I would love that. And I have cookies in my office. So if you come by, you get cookies.
All right, McKensie, thanks for coming
thanks
in today.
Thanks for having me.
Stick around. I'll be back with more right after this.
You want to feel connected, at one with your world. Informed, included, and inspired. So no matter where you are, when important things happen, we're here at all hours, in the moment, on every screen in your life. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. We investigate and inform, give back to the community, build the local economy, even save lives. America's number one source for news, weather, and information. And unlike any other news source, we're here. 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 And here. We are broadcasters. Always here for you. Wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Lead paint poisoning affects 1 million children today. If you're pregnant or have young children and your home was built before 1978, you could be at risk. Learn how to protect your family. To find your home's danger zones, the health effects, or just to find help, log on to leadfreekids.org.
And welcome back. Hey, let's take a look at some sports real quick. Robinson Cano homered twice and drove in four runs. And Hisashi Iwakuma, he struck out a season-high 10. Seattle Mariners romped the slumping Kansas City Royals 11-2 last night. Now, the AL Central leading Royals have dropped 12 of 17. And their magic number for clinching the division still remains at 3. And Jake Arrieta said he didn't feel sharp and that he was a little bit off last night. Now, the National League Cy Young Award candidate still tossed a three-hitter. Arrieta became the first pitcher in the major leagues to reach 20 victories, and Chris Bryant set the Cubs rookie record for home runs, and Chicago inched closer to a playoff berth with a 4-0 win over the Milwaukee Brewers. Can you believe it? The Cubs are going to make the playoffs. I hope they don't have a Bartman again this year if they do get in the playoffs. You know, remember, Back to the Future in 2015, remember it was up there, Cubbies win. So there you go. Let's take a look at your weather. 74 degrees, starting to warm up a little bit. Relative humidity is coming down, 69%. The winds are picking up a little bit. They're out of the south at 17, and the barometric pressure is on the rise. Looking at our 7-day, remember there is a 80% chance of rain today. 20 tomorrow, Friday. Going to be beautiful for Friday night football. Saturday, going to be good too. Summer, even though it's fall, summer is still hanging around.
Keep up to date with the latest information from TV23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays, here on TV23.
I think someone at my friend's school has this thing called autism. My friend's brother's son has autism. My neighbor's son has autism. My son has autism.
Autism is getting closer to home. Today, one in 110 children is diagnosed with autism. That's a 600% increase in the last 20 years. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 88. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org.